Thomas Frank Barry. We begin by asking, how could this confident young man, so full of promise, end up like this? What went so horribly wrong? Tom had a normal childhood with his brother David and his very, very young mother. He did all the normal things kids do, like 18 holes in the living room. As a hip adolescent handyman, he cut a pretty young thing named Mary Ann out of the crowd, courted her, and got her graduated from grade school. As Tom became scruffier and harder to look at, Mary Ann opted for a period of self-induced blindness, lasting several years. She did develop an acute sense of sound that helped her later become a speech pathologist. Tom, of course, graduated from college. Mary Ann got a note from her teacher and skipped middle school that day. They promptly married and he got her barefoot and pregnant. They did manage to raise two beautiful girls, Blakely and Caitlin, and later a handsome lad, Zach. Tom was a good father, taking the family on ski vacations and doing daddy-daughter dances. Supplemental homeschooling seemed to help Zach especially. Tom also showed Zach the fine art of nude bathing and taught Mary Ann how to check the kids for head lice. With all of this going for him, how could things go so badly awry? Next, we'll look at the downward spiral of Thomas F. Barry, looking for answers which may help us all. Dressed for success, Tom tried his hand at business, here at Rex Environmental. But that business failed, a sad scenario that depressed friends and family. From there, he moved from job to job. Whirligig vendor, and hanging out with the Whirligig King of Canada. Pizza vendor, here seen holding his first and last 50 cents. Ditch digger, which lasted just one hole. Then, however, he persuaded a much younger man to join his empire. They tried a moving business, but it didn't pay well. Pool cleaning. But neither one could swim. Even exotic cooking. That went badly. Tom went solo and tried political neighborhood organizer, but his candidate never won. Singer in a lounge band, but his wretched voice ruined them. And lounge piano man, but no bread in the jar. And most recently, part-time security for political candidates, shown here with Joan Wadsworth, this photo taken just prior to Dateline's investigation into her lurid sex life. And most recently, guarding the future president of the United States, a Mr. Charles Willis. But the most successful venture during these years was male modeling, with his boy toy and blood brother Daryl. Together, they rocked the white male, redneck, coonskin cap-wearing fashion world. Tom tried to find his sense of self-worth in sports fetishes, but there was always an obstacle. Running was a challenge because he always had to stop and take a dump. So he tried others. At the end of each day, he was inevitably overwhelmed with self-doubt and took a nap. When he wakes up, we'll tackle Tom's sexual identity journey. Early on, Tom apparently was conflicted about his manhood, as evidenced by this cheesecake shot with the twin sisters. But signs of this inner conflict popped up gradually, like when he greased up an occasional friend for unknown private purposes, or when he made friends drive naked. Nude bathing with male companions. He finally made his choice to be a woman trapped in a man's body and invited others too weak of mind to resist his will. At the end of each day, he still couldn't figure out who he was, so he took a nap. The key to the demise of Mr. Barry may be our witness to his conflicted personhood. This exodus from identity began rather innocently as larger-than-life personalities.
Things are getting weird, things are getting tough. Nothing's making sense, but you keep on looking up. They tell you to be true, you're trying every day to keep it on the real. Still, you gotta find a way to make your mama happy, to make your papa proud. You wanna turn it up, but all you hear is tone it down. So gather around, I'm here to say, you'll never make everybody's day. But while you're around, you might as well catch the tiger by its tail. Everybody just get on, get on, get on, get started and go on, go on, go on. Everybody just hold on.
Perhaps it was the Joker costume that began this alternate reality, when the frozen smile would not and could not leave his face, or the Sammy Davis Jr. act that was so hauntingly real. He really was Sammy. Here, doing business with his acidic blood brother, Ishmael Goldman. Maybe it's the portrayal of Woodrow at the Victorian Festival, singing Old Man River at the duck race each year. What for others was a weekend of fun gradually gained control of him as he flaunted his cow panties. His mustache got longer and longer, and he began to actually be Woodrow, with somewhat scary eyes. All of this came to fruition when he was sadly escorted out of town for shooting a dog in exchange for a poke. And it ended as a homeless derelict. But the final oblivion was just this past year, when he consorted with other undead persons. He almost left his wife for another, and another. If only this were the end of it, but sadly, these shots were taken just yesterday morning on his way to work. How can this man make it back to reality? What is the bridge over these troubled waters that will move him forward to a better future? Perhaps the answer is all around us. Perhaps George Bailey had it right. No man is a failure who has friends. Thomas Barry and the city of Detroit can recover through the consistent love of friends and family. Tom knows this. He has hordes of friends. So on this eve of Tom's six-decade celebration, we raise our glass to toast the man, the survivor, who mastered the theater of consciousness and has remained conscious through all of this.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do. Saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I think to myself, what a wonderful world.